wrapped up. The starting fives for both teams, as we're just about ready to get this one started. Hello, basketball fans. You've got it on 2K Sports as we get set to bring you an exciting NBA basketball game. This is Kevin Harlan along with Greg Anthony and Brett Berry. David Aldridge will be reporting from the sidelines. Well, a chance to check out some stats for Eric Gordon.
And suddenly, his feel for the three-point shot has left him. It's been a tough go the past five games. The percentage from long range, not close to what it was earlier. But he's not going to give up on it, and he'll try to get it going here tonight.
And let's go straight over to David Aldridge for a report before the tip-off. Hey, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin. The Phoenix Suns have become a powerhouse in the Western Conference, but they've got plenty of competition. Chris Paul said, "I've been in the West my whole career. The West has never been easy. It's always been a beast. If you want to win it all, you've got to go through it." Guys?
It's rugged, tough road, David. No question about it. Thank you. Two very athletic teams here, Greg. A game that's sure to produce a lot of highlights.
It makes me think of Stacey Augman, one of the greatest athletes I ever played alongside.
Here's the starting group for Houston. Out on the perimeter, Green and Gordon. Christian Wood is out there with Jayshon Tate. And it's Porter in at the five. And for the Suns, Ayton is the pivot, and Crowder slides in at the four. The star backcourt of Paul and Booker are out there. And it's Bridges in at the small forward position. Crowder with it. Looking at his numbers, he averages a bit over 9 points a game. Booker outside for three. Gets the three-pointer to fall. Booker's got the opening basket of the game for Phoenix.
Going to be an all-star guard like Devin Booker. You might want to start hitting your share of triples.
Outside, Green passes it to Wood, launches it, and it's Phoenix with the rebound. They defeated the Wizards in their last game.
And really showed their depth when they needed it most. On the road, having to manufacture points.
Yeah, and watching that, all kinds of contributions and just little things that guys were doing to chip in for that win.
And credit the screen for giving him the space he needed to get to the rim.
For sure, GA allows him to come in with the sledgehammer.
Yeah, why settle for the layup when you can attack the rim and rise up like that?
Here's Gordon. The Suns getting the bucket. Doesn't go for him. Some solid defense from Ayton. To the paint. Here's the break. Crowder, the pass to Booker. Another three for Phoenix.
Just not thinking about it twice. Devin Booker with the ball. He's going to let it rip.
They're getting beat up pretty badly out there.
And I don't care what anybody says. You can't keep the status quo. If it ain't working, you got to make some changes.
Now here's Porter. 8 points his last outing. Gets it to go from beyond the arc.
Nice answer back there. Love to see the competitiveness.
Yeah, both teams finding ways to the three-point line and trying to take advantage from distance.
Total letdown by the D. Can't leave the bucket unprotected.
Absolutely. And it attacks an easy 2 points onto the lead.
Will not find a higher percentage opportunity than that.
And so here is Houston after the Suns pick up two. 11 feet away. And the rejection by Ayton.
Ayton flashing some good movement there and great timing.
Shot clock at five. Houston needs to get a shot off. Paul with the steal. Bridges left side. Over Gordon. Here's Ayton. First shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast.
They've wasted no time settling into their offense.
Porter passes to Gordon. And here in the first, approaching 3 minutes played. Inside. In the corner, Tate with it. Six on the shot clock. Sweet move. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. That one on Ayton.
Yeah, easy call.
The Rockets shooting their first free throws here tonight. One is off. And he's good on the second. And it's Phoenix's ball. They're on a 12-4 run right now. Booker looking around. And the dunk by Booker.
I like their focus coming in. Terrific execution so far.
Well, if there were four or five boxes to check in terms of the game plan tonight, they might have checked six. I mean, they're doing everything out there.
And, you know, Booker might have been a volume shooter, at least early in his career, but now he's a legit number one option for an offense.
Now, here's Green. He's certainly been a consistent piece of their offense, averaging about 14.5 points a game. Drains it from beyond the arc.
Well, if Eric Gordon gets the ball from beyond the arc, you have to respect his ability to knock those down.
Crowder against Wood. And the shot's good from Crowder. And Greg, the efficiency for Booker has grown over the years.
And no longer forcing shots. Takes what's available to him. And I believe he can be the leading scorer on a championship caliber team.
Here is Porter after the made shot from Jay Crowder. The drive by Green and the rejection by Eaton. Pass to Paul over Porter. That's good from Paul on the assist from Bridges.
Excellent all-around performance so far, hence the big lead.
Well, if I was baking up a lead, I'd add two ingredients. One would be playing smart. The other one, playing selfless. They've done that tonight. Serve it up.
And so it's Houston with it. Following the basket by Chris Paul. Gordon, the pass to Wood. That shot off the mark. Now the Suns take it the other way. They won their last game against the Rockets in Houston.
In the last meeting of these two teams, they were really sharp defensively, disrupting the flow of their offense and causing a ton of turnovers.
It was definitely that defense that carried them to that huge win that night. You have to figure they'll be primed to wreak even more havoc here in this one.
So for the Suns, JaVale McGee comes in for Ayton. And Landry Shamet subbed in for Devin Booker. And so it's Matthews with it, bringing it up now for the Houston Rockets, trailing by 13. Matthews sets a screen for Brooks. Bridges with some nice defense.
And he gets a lot of points right there at the rim, but the defense determined not to give up the easy deuce there.
Offensively, defensively, they are in total control.
Yeah, the other team a bit concerned here. They're trailing, and the lead seems to be growing.
The pass to Tate. Back to Brooks. Just five on the clock. Looking to end the run. That misses off the backboard.
Well, that mid-range J usually pretty much on the money. Maybe the timing just a little bit off on that one.
Paul kicks to Shamet. Biombo is checked in for Phoenix. Johnson comes in for Mikal Bridges. On defense, the Rockets. It's a 16-point game. Biombo finds Shamet. Five on the clock. Can't get it to fall, and he's missed the second after making his first.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Back to Matthews. Fires for three. Drills it from outside.
You can't just stop when there's a pick set up. Gotta fight over it as a defender.
That's one that the coaches will watch tomorrow with that player. You hate to see him give up in that situation.
The shot's good from Paul.
Defensively, giving up far too many open rhythm looks.
Brooks against Paul. Here's Christopher. No good on the three. Suns leading by 15. Johnson, wide open, he fires. And it's Phoenix scoring again.
I mean, as good a passer as we've ever seen in the NBA, Chris Paul setting up a great look that time.
Paul against Brooks. Pass to Tice. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
The Rockets shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night. That's good from Tice. Both free throws good from Tice. Suns leading by 15. Johnson outside. 1:03 left to play here in the first. Back to Paul. Fires the three. That one falls, coming off Johnson's feet. Paul's got seven.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Rockets trail by 18. Outside Matthews. Back to Brooks. Played in with a nice touch off the glass.
Not getting old here. Seeing him make that lead pass with perfect timing.
Paul kicks to Johnson. Passes it to Biombo. Shamet on the wing. To the inside. Fades away. It's rebounded by Houston. Defeated by the Pelicans in their last game, They'll try to put that one behind them.
I'll tell you, they played hard, they drew fouls, but they could not convert at the line.
Yeah, drawing fouls is tough, but the important part about that is when you get to the free throw line, you gotta turn those into points, and it might have cost them in that last ball game missing all those chippies.
1 second left. And so it's the Phoenix Suns in command with a 16-point lead as the buzzer sounds. They've been putting on a clinic in the paint. Shots are falling with regularity, and they are pounding it down low. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute. Well, in his rookie season, Kevin Porter came off the bench. Now he's in Houston. He's a starter. And he analyzed the change in mentality.
You know, coming off the bench, you kind of have a feel for the game already watching it. And starting, you're starting off. So just got to start fast. And I got to come in ready to play from the jump.
And when Porter gets out to a hot start, Greg, he's shown he's capable of some big nights.
And finding some success with the Rockets, Kevin, now it's all about consistency and finding ways to win games.
And glad to have you with us, folks. Second quarter of basketball. This game has not exactly been neck and neck, but plenty of time left in this one. And guys, the Suns enjoying a nice lead here.
On the attack right from the tip. They've been relentless offensively.
Well, just taking it right at the opposition and the other team right now. No answers and no way to slow them down.
So on the floor for Houston. Porter in the backcourt with Green to his side. Jayson Tate out there with Wood, and it's Gordon in at the three. And Greg, when it comes to load management, why do we see more of it now than when you play?
Well, for me, the science of sport has evolved, and it's not just the athlete, it's the technology and the science that goes into making a better athlete. That's why you're seeing load management far more acceptable to the masses now, understanding that this is about the long game.
And breaking down some numbers here, the hustle stats for Phoenix.
Great hustle defensively through the first half, contesting everything and racking up the block shots.
Another big aspect has to be the fast break and transition play, really looking to go up tempo tonight.
Outside, Porter. Pass to Tate. Out to the right wing. Shot clock at 5. Gordon with it. Now guarded by Ayton. And the rejection by Ayton.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
Here's Booker. Dives to the hoop. Green with the rebound.
We're not going to see that very often. The defense in the vicinity, but still, he's not one to blow layups.
Here's Porter. Rejected by Crowder.
That's just good defense as Crowder in the right spot.
And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. The Houston Rockets are rebuilding. And that's a hard pivot for a team that, until last season, was pursuing titles. The new front office has been candid. It's presented challenges as they look to go young and stack up draft picks. They plan to make constant bets on unproven talent as they build toward the future. Kevin?
All right, David, thank you. And Ayton throws it down.
And Jay Crowder moving it to the open man.
Rockets trail by 18. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
Here's Green. Wood in the post. He's guarded by Booker. Wood with the bucket. Wood's got 4 this quarter.
Now there's some easy offense there. Keep finding looks in that area, and their shooting percentages tonight are going to be off the charts.
Now here's Ayton. Against Washington, he was really on his game. On the wing, Booker. That's a 2 from Crowder. Good. A nice assist from Booker. Crowder's got his second bucket of the night.
Crowder not hesitating on the offensive end.
The Rockets making a switch here. Martin's checked in.
And now a chance to take a look at some numbers for Wood.
What a run he's been on over the past few weeks. He's averaging 19 points per game, 11 rebounds, and 2 assists. And guys, he can just explode for points anytime he steps on the court.
Well, he looks to score, and he looks to score often.
Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Outside, Green, a three ball. It's rebounded by Paul.
You know what, though? Sometimes you can be too open. I think it may have surprised him, and that's why he missed. And with Chris Paul, he makes this team work, gets the most out of his teammates, and has done that wherever he's played.
Here's Booker. The Rockets making the shot. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. As you said, Paul's teams often overachieve in the standings.
People still underestimate his impact. Sets up and improves his guys as well as anyone. And he's the engine to this whole operation.
This is his first chance at the line tonight.
And what a season he's had at the foul line thus far. 86% from the line.
Free throw, good, Booker.
And you got to love Devin Booker and the way he just competes no matter what the score is and no matter where the team is sitting in the standing.
Both free throws good from Booker. After a whistle, we often see players demanding their coach challenge the call. Greg, were there plays you wish you could have challenged in your career?
Oh, goodness, absolutely. But the game was just so different back then, and we had other ways of resolving issues and letting the refs know when we maybe didn't appreciate a call.
No good from outside.
He's cooled down a little bit after draining those 2 3-pointers in the first quarter.
Porter against Paul. From 15 feet away, Phoenix grabs the miss. Crowder's got his 5th rebound right now in the game. Ayton, a screen on Martin. Crowder inside, covered by Martin. And the shot's good from Crowder. Crowder's got 6.
Getting bumped after the shot, no problem for Jay Crowder.
Outside, Green, from outside the arc, it's good from long range.
Now that's a high percentage look when the D doesn't fight over the screen.
Yeah, the coach over there just asking for one simple thing, and that's some effort got burned on that one.
Phoenix leading by 17. Booker outside. Crowder inside. He dishes it to Paul. Over Martin. It's rebounded by Houston. And that one's good, Ayton. Now Porter. He's been a reliable scorer for him as he's averaging up over 13 points a game. Tate with the ball. He's against Crowder. And a wide open look for Porter. Off target with his 3.
And the stroke definitely lacking confidence this quarter. Nothing on target.
And the pass to Paul. Ayton, a screen on Porter. From 15 feet away, Tate with the rebound.
Shot didn't fall, but that play worked well to get a good look at the basket.
Yeah, an efficient offensive possession. They found the look that they wanted, just didn't go in.
And Porter, here we go. Jay Crowder pulls it in. Crowder's got his 6th rebound on the night.
But his shooting this quarter has to be a huge concern, especially when they're behind like this. Can he find the rhythm?
And credit the screen for giving him the space he needed to get to the rim.
For sure, GA allows him to come in with the sledgehammer.
Yeah, well, he settled for the layup when you can attack the rim and rise up like that.
big group substitution here for Phoenix. JaVale McGee's checked in for DeAndre Ayton. Biombo checks in for Jay Crowder. Cameron Johnson's checked in for Bridges. And Landry Shamet subbed in for Chris Paul. And it's the Rockets with the ball. Outside Matthews. Booker against Brooks. Houston moving the ball around. And Tice gets it to go.
And that's back-to-back threes. The D just seems to be slacking off a little bit.
Johnson surveying the floor. Pass to Biombo. On the wing, Booker. Lock at six. Now, here's Shamet. T right on him. And the Suns get it back. Got a hand on it, and they're able to recover. There's the pick. The tray. He can't get that one to fall. And Houston the other way now. Looking ahead to their next game, playing at New Orleans, they'll match up against the Pelicans. That will conclude their brief two-game road trip. Suns leading by 18. Johnson outside. Combo dishes to Booker. Now, here's Shamet. Defense is right there. Driving to the basket. Misses the layup. Outside Matthews. From deep, Brooks. And that one released in time, but no good. A dominating first half of basketball. And so far, hasn't been close. Suns lead by 18. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Chris, hot start, cool finish. What happened out there?
Well, we came out with a lot of energy, but in the second quarter, it died down a little bit. You know, it's real. Everybody's very excited. You know, our team's excited. Their team's excited. Officials excited. You know what I mean? So we just got to calm down and play a little bit.
And I'm excited. Thanks, Chris. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway.
Welcome to halftime. Glad you could join us. It's been a clash of the Titans at the center spot so far.
I mean, who doesn't love a five-star matchup like this? Both players showing their competitive nature, igniting their teammates' fire with these performances. Expect this level of play to continue in the second half.
And right now, let's talk about that monster first half for the Suns.
They were in such a groove that entire first half, especially on the offensive end. Good play calling, good execution, and by and large, they take good, not good, great shots.
That is more than enough of us. Let's send you back to the game, Kevin Harlan and crew, with the second half.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. You know, guys, Devin Booker has been exceptional here.
Oof. That first half looked like a dunk contest mixtape was just destroying the rim.
Yeah, the defense has got to be a little bit embarrassed. There is no reason why he should just be on top of that rim.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. Our second half of basketball and presented by Gatorade. Let's see who's all fueled up and on the floor to start the third. Setting the floor for the Suns. Up it forward, they'll have Bridges and Crowder. The star backcourt of Paul and Booker are out there. And it's Ayton in at seven. Now here's Ayton. The shot that time, not on target. Good D by Wood.
Big question mark was Ayton, and could he anchor a defense? He's answered those.
Gordon against Crowder. To the middle. Wood passes to Tate. The kick out to Porter. Buries it from three-point range. Porter's got 6 points. Well, Brent, you said it. Defense now a strength of what Ayton brings to the table.
Well, that was the point he had to prove, Kevin. As a big guy, what could he do? Every night, you know, if you're not getting the ball down on the inside defensively on the interior, how can I impact the game? He's been patient with it. He's learned it. And now he's embraced the fact that he can make that kind of contribution. That's the guy they're going to keep going to, as they should. The lead's only going up if they keep feeding him.
Back to Gordon. And it's Ayton with the rebound. Ayton's got 8 rebounds in this game. And it's Paul penetrating, and the layup's good off the glass. 9 points in the game so far.
Not a lot of resistance on the inside, and they're taking full advantage.
Rockets trail by 19. Porter passes to Wood. And it's Phoenix with the rebound. Ayton's got rebound number 9 now. What an effort here tonight. Passes to Booker. Ayton, a screen on Gordon. Here's Booker. Takes it inside. And he drops in the layup off the glass. And the Suns lead by 21.
And that bucket adds to what has been a big difference in points in the paint between the two teams.
And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. Well, the three-point shot of Mikal Bridges seemed to abandon him early in his NBA career. Coach Monty Williams said he developed a hitch in his release. But Bridges got in the lab with the coaching staff, changing his shot midway through season 2. And the results speak for themselves. Guys?
He had a career year shooting, that's for sure. I admire his work ethic. D.A., thank you. Trying to find Wood, gets it to him.
And there's a lot of power behind Woods' dunks. He's not going to get cheated when he takes it to the rim.
And that last look brought to you by the AT&T 5G Slam King. Booker outside. There's the three. Falls right in. He is 8 for 11 with that shot.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flame.
Yeah, he's the guy that you want to go to right now, trying to put this one away.
Well, they've been better than good on the glass today, and there is a glaring discrepancy between these two teams in that area.
And there's the call on DeAndre Ayton. That'll be his second foul of the game.
That's a bad miscue, but I think they've done a really good job keeping control of the ball throughout the game.
And we just got a second look there at the exceptional mobile one block.
Sharp instincts on D there. Just timing when to rise up and swat that one away.
Martin, he's checked in for Christian Wood. Rockets trail by 19. Gordon deciding where to go with it. Outside, Green. Back to Gordon. Jacks up a three. And it's Devin Booker with the rebound.
Hate to say it, but if they're still trailing at the final buzzer, a lot of this is going to be felt by him. His shooting tonight has just been atrocious.
And this is how you want to come out of the half. Prolific and efficient.
Well, the thing is, they're controlling the pace right now, and if that was the mantra for them at halftime, they've carried it out.
And the Rockets with possession here, following the score by Phoenix. He blocks it again!
A defensive stalwart so far. That's 6 blocks.
Greg protecting the rim. Love the hustle. And Phoenix making a change here. Biombo's checked in. Here's Green. He's got 6. Traps in the tray. Green's got 9.
Well, the D has done a very poor job at contesting him from outside, guys. He's tearing into them right now, and they cannot stop him.
Now here's Booker. He's got 21. The baseline J off the mark. Porter against Paul. Outside, Green. into the lane. Feeds to Martin. And there's the whistle. 3-second violation. Let's take a look at the 2K leaderboard to find out who the best defenders have been over the past month. Here are your steals leaders. Fifth on the list, Chris Paul.
Really been fantastic defensively this run for him. He's had more than his share of steals, and now he's looking to get more.
Now here's Paul. 9 points in the game so far. Over Porter. It's rebounded by Houston. Pass to Gordon. Over in the corner, Green. Martin the screen. 4 on the shot clock. 11 feet away. Green, no luck.
Maybe there are ways to contribute that don't involve shooting the basketball. That's the best way that maybe he can help them out in trying to win this game.
Bridges with it. And it's Martin picking him up. Now the feed to Biombo. And then Biombo hit the dunk.
Well, he passes to the wide open man, Bridges, developing some team chemistry.
And it's Gordon with the ball. He brings it up for the Houston Rockets. Timeout called, the Rockets.
And with Mikal Bridges, he's a player who knows his role and plays his role as well.
I think he's one of those guys who comes from a great system. He came into the league with incredible discipline and incredible awareness of where it is he can impact the game. And that's why you see the 3-and-D effect that Mikal Bridges has had on the NBA.
So for the Suns, JaVale McGee's checked in for Jay Crowder. Johnson comes in for Mikal Bridges. And Landry Shamet subbed in for Booker. And there's the pass to Christopher. Back to Brooks. Launches a three. The rebound by Johnson. Phoenix leading by 20. Pass to Paul. McGee with it. Good, and Paul gets the assist. Paul's got his third assist on the night.
Those defenders just look a little bit gassed. I mean, they're getting pushed around on that low block.
Houston's gone 3 of 7 from three-point range here in quarter number 3. Paul against Brooks. He feeds it to Matthews. Out to Brooks. The three. Good on the triple. Brooks has got 5 points so far.
And really, as the three-pointers keep dropping, you get the sense that the frustration is mounting for the defense.
The Suns have gone 7 of 10 on their field goal attempts here in the third. Paul passes to Johnson. McGee is screen on Matthews. Goes back up. And the layup good by McGee. McGee's got 4 points this quarter.
When you're trying to claw your way back into a game, you cannot allow second chance opportunities.
Yeah, those are tough. You get back into the game by working harder than the other team, not the other way around. They're just going to extend this lead.
Matthews finds Brooks. 6 to shoot. To the paint. Tice passes to Matthews. Over Johnson. Matthews, no good.
Well, if you believe in the numbers, that mid-range shot is not a high-value shot, even with little or no defense on you.
Here's Paul. No good on that one. And it's Houston the other way. 41 seconds left here in the third quarter. Fires it up. Rebound by the Suns.
Yeah, that miss might stick with him for a little while. That's kind of a shoot-around jumper if I've ever seen one.
No good on the shot. A bit long that time.
Teammates right now covering up for the type of off performance he's having. In terms of scoring, this has not been his best night.
Brooks feeling it out a bit. Down low. Here's Şengün. The Rockets again can't hit.
With nobody getting a hand in his face in that painted area, that's a miss he's going to be disappointed with.
And as we conclude the third quarter, pretty much a blowout. It's been a one-sided affair. Suns ahead, running away with it. And time for the short break, and stay right where you are. The fourth quarter is coming up next. And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. Taking a look at the Rockets. Porter in the backcourt with Green to his side. Jayson Tate out there with Matthews. And it's Wood in at the five down low. Now here's Booker. Ayton trying to break free. Good D by Wood. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
And there's the call on Devin Booker. That's his first foul. Greg, last season, we saw a lot of opinions about the play-in tournament, especially from players. Where did you fall on that thinking?
Well, I'm going to put on my fan hat right now, Kevin, and I thought it was exciting. I mean, seeing the stakes get raised for those teams that are right on the edge, I think it brings more interest for teams. But if I was still playing, I probably wouldn't like it if I had locked up the playoffs and still had to go play to earn a berth.
Now, here's Bridges. Booker dishes to Ayton, and the basket is good. Ayton's got the first points up on the board here in the fourth for the Suns. And so Green will bring it up for the Houston Rockets. Pass to Porter. 1 minute now into this fourth quarter, and that one off the back of the rim and in. Porter against Paul. Over Porter. The shot by Paul, no good. Rockets trail by 21. On the wing, Green. Defended by Booker. Now here's Gordon. Just five to shoot. Basket counts.
Great finish from Gordon in traffic. You like to see the smaller guys operate down low as long as they're patient.
Suns leading by 19. Outside Crowder from 12 feet out. They get it again. Ayton. And Ayton throws it down.
And a better box out saves them 2 points there.
It didn't seem like anybody was really aware there to go and collect that rebound in the possession.
And here's Gordon. Inside. And he bangs it home with one hand.
Remarkable pass off that pick and roll from EG there. He might have been able to take that shot, but wisely threaded the needle.
For Phoenix, they've gone 2 for 5 on field goal attempts in the fourth quarter. Here's Paul. It's rebounded by Houston. Woods got his fifth rebound right now in the game.
Not great numbers, but great effort in this one. Sounds funny, but I think he's been a positive for them.
Here's Wood from 17 feet out. Crowder pulls it in. Crowder's got 8 rebounds in this game. Booker against Gordon. Bridges, no one around him. And it's off from 3-point range. Rockets trail by 19. Third minute of action now gone here in the fourth. Poked loose. Pass to Tate. Fires the three. Rebound by the Suns. Earlier, they held a 23-point lead. They get to take on the Bulls at Chicago after this one. And that'll be the first of a 2-game road trip for them. Nice ball movement by Phoenix. Ayton sets the pick for Booker. In for another field goal. A sublime 9 of 14 on the night.
Doing a lot of nice work now from the field. He's helped get them this lead, and now he's helped them keep it.
Outside, Porter, the three. Another miss by Houston. Suns leading by 21. To the inside. Here's Ayton. Kicks it out to Booker. 2021 was an unusual season, to say the least, for players, coaches. Brent, there was a lot to adapt to. How do you think you would have handled the condensed schedule?
It's a good question, Kevin. I think just obviously you'd have work to do, and I'd show up every day to do it. And I commend a lot of the players, not just in terms of the level of competition. It was all the other things that they had to do in order to suit up on a nightly basis, not playing in front of crowds. I mean, that is a love of the game type of season that, of course, I hope we never see again because of the circumstances around it. But the players do deserve a lot of credit. And the fans that hung in there and started to show up towards the end of the year to support the players deserve a lot of credit as well. And I'm glad we're through that.
Martin's checked in for Houston. Phoenix has gone 5 of 9 when they put up the three-point shot tonight. Paul looking around. Porter pulls it in. Porter's got 4 rebounds now tonight. Gordon kicks to Martin. Now the pass to Wood. Up and in on the layup.
And you know, he's got a wide range of skills inside. Wood's ready for whatever the defense throws at him.
Phoenix leading by 19. Here's Booker with the drive. No good with the layup.
Things are going south right now. This is not the type of shooting that his teammates expect from him.
Outside, Gordon. And the wide open shot from Green. Misses the three.
I'm shocked that didn't turn into 3 points. I mean, he makes you pay on those nearly every time.
And Ayton gets double teamed. And Booker kicks to Bridges. 6 on the shot clock. Gordon against Paul. And again, it's the Suns missing. Rockets trail by 19.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Porter a screen on Bridges. Outside Crowder. The shot will not fall. And Houston the other way now. There's Porter with the three. Bangs home the trifecta. Porter's got 5 points now in the quarter.
And perimeter scoring, I have to imagine it was a topic of discussion at halftime.
Maybe trying to find a little bit more space and ball movement to get guys open at the three-point line.
And now a moment to present the New Balance Player of the Game, DeAndre Ayton.
And in terms of his shooting, this has been one of the more accurate performances you'll ever see. I mean, he's been in constant motion, creating a lot of good looks for himself. But still, even when you're wide open, you expect to miss some of the time. And that has not been the case here tonight. This guy has made everything.
He's played up to his full potential tonight, and he's been playing to the crowd, too. He loves being the star attraction, even if it doesn't happen on a regular basis. .146 left to play in the final quarter. Down low. Porter looking it over. He takes it in. Paul with the defensive effort. And so Booker will bring it up for the Suns. Earlier, they held a 23-point lead.
And this is going to end in a lopsided victory. I love the tenacity and aggressiveness, as well as the ability to close. You really got to give it up here for Phoenix.
Two great rebounding teams.
And these guys worked just a little bit harder tonight, and that was the edge they needed.
And so when you look at the season record, this one will tally up win number 43 on the year. And one of the key components to this victory, if not the biggest, was the incredible performance for DeAndre Ayton.
He was really important under the basket, making the plays down low and getting position to pull in rebounds.
Gordon against Bridges, and the basket by Gordon.
Nice change of speed from Gordon on the drive to the hoop. Love that aggressiveness.
46 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Wood against Ayton. And Ayton gets double teamed. Here's Bridges, and the layup falls. And the Suns lead by 18.
And once they smelled blood in the water, you could see the killer instinct take over.
Yeah, up until that point, a competitive game. But once they broke through that barrier, it was all them. Complete control.
Here is Porter after Mikal Bridges' bucket. 20 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Clock at six. Back to Porter. And again, it's the Rockets from deep. Booker outside. So it's the Suns winning easily here. A confident win, and one where they clearly showed the greater effort.
Yeah, I mean, it was a solid performance, particularly here at home. And I think they built off that edge of being here and play with just a little more confidence than their opponent.
And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. Chris, big win tonight. What do you think was the biggest factor?
I mean, I don't know. You know, it was just our defense. You know, obviously our offense fared off of it. Guys made open shots, but I think we really locked down defensively, and that's what we're trying to make sure is that we're a defensive team every night.
Well, you were a defensive team tonight, Chris. Thanks for your time. Kevin?
All right, David. Great job. Thanks so much. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Brent Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan, along with our 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. We'll see you next time.